So my name is Jürgen Schafflechner and I'm an assistant professor at South Asia Institute in Heidelberg. And I have written a book on Hinglaaj Devi, which is a Hindu pilgrimage place in Balochistan in the Las Bela district. And this book is going to come out in a few months in Pakistan. There are 51, 52 Shaktapithas, depending on the source. And Hinglaaj, some of the sources, some of the Sanskrit texts say that Hinglaaj is the first of them. And so it's a very important place of pilgrimage for Hindus all over the world, of course also for Hindus in Pakistan. And so I wanted to see how this place has developed. There are a lot of stories that are connected with this. One of the stories goes back to the mythological times when Shiva was married to Sati. And since Shiva was a yogi and was just wearing the skin of an animal, Sati's father, who was a king, was not very happy with her choice. And so when Sati's father had a huge ritual, he invited everyone in the Hindu pantheon, but not Shiva. Sati was very upset about this, and so she jumped into the Yagyakund, so into the fire, the sacrificial fire. Shiva, when he heard about this, got very angry, took the body of Sati out of the fire and started a terrible dance, the Tandava. And in this dance, because it was so frightening, the whole world almost was about to be destroyed. So Vishnu, another god of the Hindu pantheon, came and cut the body of Sati into pieces to calm down Shiva, who was in this frenzy. And wherever parts of the body fell all over South Asia, there you have these Shakti pits, these seats of power. And so the tradition says that the upper part, the Brahmarandra of Sati's body, has fallen in Hinglaaj, and this is why this is one of the most important places to visit for Hindus. Actually, a problem that I had. I came to Hinglaaj, which just because of the building of the road had this power vacuum, so to say. And I wanted to figure out books and texts about Hinglaaj. So everybody to whom I talked, everybody told me, well, you know, XYZ says so and so, but that's not true. My story, the story that our community has, is the actual story. So this word of proper, actual, Khalis, Sachibat Kyahe, this came often up very often. So it's a methodological question that was a problem for me, because who am I then to choose whose story is wrong and whose story is false? So what I did myself is I took myself a little bit out of the equation, and I was not interested in which story is right and which story is wrong, but I became interested in the process of how certain stories become right or wrong. And this is the process that I called with the metaphor of solidification. So I looked at how over the last 30 years it was possible that a coherent story actually came up. And everybody, every person I talked to, of course, would claim that their story is true. This is why I call this variety of truth claims. And so solidification is the attempt to write a history of how one of these truth claims became the most powerful and is now the so to say, the general, the universal, the real story at the shrine. But when you look at its history, you see it's only just one particular story that became hegemonic in our day and age. We actually don't know how old it is. We can only guess. I think, good proof that from the 14th century on, people actually go on pilgrimage there. That's, I think, pretty solid. But you have to see the whole story from this. It was such an aloof and distant place that there was no coherent story about Hinglaaj that you can find in any of the books. And it's clear why, because people from Bengal, for example, if they would go to Hinglaaj and write about their experience, they would write it in Bengali. People would write in Gujarati, in Sindhi, and so on. And only now, over the last, let's say, 40 years, 35 to 40 years, all of these books had a platform to come together. And these platforms, actually multiple platforms, but two of the most important are, one, the April Mela, where people actually physically meet and can talk about Hinglaaj and what they think that the actual story is there. And the other platform is, of course, social media. So what happened is that people encountered this plurality of voices, and some institution needed to come in to organize all of these voices into a right and wrong, a good and bad, so to say, into one story that is institutionally supported and one story that is institutionally not supported. And I'm not saying that the HSM, the Hinglaaj Seva Mandal, is the sole actor in this, but I'm saying that a lot of communities and welfare organizations, one of the most important being the Hinglaaj Seva Mandal, has a very big role in solidifying one coherent narrative at the shrine.